Never. Veteran Israeli negotiator Monte Cristal with us now. Monte, we have talked over the last months of the Trump administration several times about the word regional, this talk of a potential regional deal, of Saudi Arabia playing a big role in it. When we see the tables turning like this, all those countries getting together with those condemnations today against Trump, against Israel, is any of that still on the table?
Oh yeah, everything is still on the table. This is just a must said, what we call in sometimes in intense negotiations, we call it ventilation. It's a necessary ventilation. People need to vent, people need to air their frustration. Of course, it was frustrated for the Palestinian. It was frustrated because Donald Trump did not consult with them. They were left aside. So they made a statement which there's nothing new. The beautiful with all this Trump Jerusalem issue is that there is nothing new. Just it's really a warm soup.
But they might be venting, but at this point these countries are faced with a president who says something that in the Muslim world is inflammatory. Can they afford even a month down the line to walk it back and sit down with Trump and pretend like it never happened?
Well, that's the Middle East. It will happen if they will have a stronger interest. The big challenge is the current stalemate, the current political stalemate. And that's, again, Donald Trump is cooking or overcooking his big deal peace plan. I don't know whether he missed the train and the opportunity to put it on the table, because whatever he will bring, if he will bring something new, he will face a dramatic, as we saw President Abbas. He will see parties who are very, very reluctant. If 2 or 3 weeks ago they were eager or waiting to whatever it will be, now they are very, very reluctant and very suspicious towards the Trump administration. It's not that I believe that there was something beautiful or attractive in this package or deal, but the process that started between Israeli and the Sunni axis definitely got you know, a drawback as a result of this Jerusalem declaration. But
it's
not dead, because the fundamental issue, the stalemate, the realities on the ground, this did not change. Israel is not accelerating its settlement construction. Palestinians are not stopping the security cooperation. So as long as it stays on the declaration level, see how stable to some extent is the situation between North Korea and the U.S.
Well,
statement-wise.
If that's what we're comparing things to North Korea and Israel, that's not the, you know, that doesn't bode too well for anyone here in the Middle East.
If we zoom into our region a little bit, and less regionally, what do you think is the likelihood of this picture that President Abbas is painting? Negotiations with Israel in the future without the U.S. Do you see that as happening?
Oh yeah, actually yes. The Israeli Oslo process was without the U.S. The Israeli-Jordanian negotiations were without the U.S. Mediating. Israelis and Palestinians, as long as there is a political will, Israel and Palestinians really do not need U.S. as a mediator or as a third party. We do need the international community in order to facilitate, mainly to guarantee, whatever Israelis and Palestinians will be able to agree.
The international community is an amorphous term. Is there one nation, one leader you think could play that role?
Well, I think it no longer exists. U.S., since the days of the Obama administration and the Obama's attitude towards the Arab Spring and his completely wrong reading of realities in the Middle East and definitely in Trump era, U.S. lost its dominant role in the Middle East. The only advantage that the U.S. still has, putting aside the vast knowledge base of the processes, which none of the other stakeholders have, is the capability, the potential capability to twist Israel's arms when a decision needs to be taken. I'm not sure that America's Trump still has this capacity.
Well, I'm glad to see, though, that after being through several negotiations yourself here in the Middle East, you still find some optimism.
Oh, yeah.